You know what? I was crusty in November, but I was like, you know, it's my duty.
Oh.
To show you
mm-hmm.
that I can be any girl you want me to be.
Oh, okay. Oh, and what are you right now?
572. Call me.
What are you right now?
Gee, bad bitch.
Look at you. What's? First of all, welcome to the December content. It channel shut down. It's not happening for us.
Not again! Not again! Not again!
So this month we're going in harder with music. It is December after all.
You vibe.
Hopefully this is also just a shout out to Destruction Boys, but they're gonna put me on their team because la la la. I really do want to be a part of.
We were told they are construction
girls. I broke it's a little back in. Anyway, today we have, I mean, the one and only Nyamazi Tinasimbazi. And we are wanting to hear, what is this person listening to? We've asked them to prepare some music for us, which we will take you guys through. But here is our guest.
Hi guys, we have a very special guest.
Yes.
In a Billy, in the car. It's really on the car. She goes by the name of Nadia Nakai.
You actually made a Twitter video.
Yeah.
Where I don't know where it is right now.
We'll find it.
I don't know if you remember the Summers. They was the Summers. They wanted to find out who would you like to be the host.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I remember that.
Yeah. And then people were like, oh my gosh, okay, cool. Then other people suggested YouTubers to be, you know, the peeps.
Yeah.
And then like I pretend to be like an announcement person and like I'm doing the category and you are one of my winners. I think it was record of the year, song of the year, something.
That's what's
up. I'll tag you in the video.
Declare in the name of the Lord.
Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Well, welcome to Pop Culture. Thank you. Please let the people know who you are, what you do, and where you're from.
And where you're from.
Okay, well, my name is Nadia Nakai, aka Braga. I am a rapper signed to Family Tree. I'm based in Joburg. I'm South African, but I've got some heritage, so.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. How are you
going? How are you feeling though about, you know, home being
I'm
released of,
yeah, of
Darab?
Guys, I think got
did
very
you just
tricky,
call that 80-something-year-old man Darab?
96.
Rob.
Nine.
Oh.
I mean,
he's
an elder.
Yeah, no, he is. He's an ancestor.
Dinosaur.
Hey, I'm happy because my thing is that it's like, ever since Zim got independence, they've only known Robert Mugabe, and he's been like in power for 37 years.
That's
it's like it's a long time. I mean, before him it was Ian Smith, and he was the prime minister of Rhodesia, which is like Zimbabwe back in the day. You know what I mean? And I'm just happy that even though if nothing changes immediately, at least the fact that there's a change that happened
in power, yeah.
And it just gives hope, I guess.
It does for something new,
yeah.
So today's episode is gonna be very, very fun. Okay. We've never actually done this before to jam. We've jammed together in the car, but we've never had a guest that we jam with.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So obviously,
our month, for December is all the month. What? The month for December. Anyway, the theme for the month is like music-y and like what inspires us through music, how we enjoy it,
okay.
And just like the essence of like it groove,
okay.
You know, just music supersedes like just everything. It's like a universal language and it's just awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
So obviously that's why we asked you to please send through your list of tracks.
Because
we want to let the viewers know what is Braga listening to.
Yeah.
And obviously we gave you a couple of categories.
Yeah.
So you gave us three summer bangers that you're listening to right now.
Yeah.
So I want you to just speak on the bangers that you chose. And what is, I think, for me, I think the summer bangers right now, like South Africa's in an amazing place with
my
music.
God.
I'm an unofficial ambassador of Destruction Boys.
Okay. Yeah, there's a group called Construction Girls.
I'm supposed to be in that group. So just talk us through some of the tracks that you know that you selected that are your summer bangers.
Okay, well, one that I'm listening to a lot that I absolutely love is Zakwe featuring Casper. Yo, 17.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yo, I love that jam so much. It's so
cool. Volume. Hey. Evo. Evo.
Teza.
Hey. They played at Migos.
Oh, it's too much.
Yes.
I wish it was my song. That's how much I love this song. I wish it wasn't Zakwe's song.
Have you seen the video?
Yes.
It's
so thuggish. And I love those kind of thuggish kind of songs.
Yeah.
So talk us through this track and what, like, what gets you hype about the song? Because I mean, Zakwe's been in the game for quite a while.
He has, and he's an amazing artist.
Why are you calling him Zakwe?
What am I supposed to say? I'm going to roll like I'm like, why? Why hold that bag?
Oh, you don't say quite so, do you? Okay, no, it's fine.
Don't be an enemy.
Okay, it's fine.
Appropriate. I feel like we all know who Zakwe is.
Do you know what I mean? Who Zakwe?
There we go.
I love the song. I like the production. It's amazing. He's an amazing lyricist.
Mm.
And of course, he's featuring Casper, and I like all Casper's verses. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the line where he says, I was born a loser, I'm a winner now. Your favorite rapper is a singer now. Those kind of vibes.
That's yeah.
Kind of like little sobs.
Do you feel like artists that have been in the game for a long time?
Yeah.
That they should remain to what we've always known them to be, or should they transform with the time? Because I know, like, I'm trying to think, like, Kelly Rowland, and there was someone else, I think Whitney Houston for a little while, just before she had passed away.
Yeah.
They got a lot of backlash for, like, kind of not necessarily conforming to the current sound. But
yeah.
Do you think, as an artist who's been in the game for long, that you should just kind of stick to what you've always been? Or is it a thing of, yes, transform with the game? Because, I mean, this sound is, for me at least, is very unfamiliar to exactly. him.
Yeah.
But it was such a refreshing thing, especially because we saw him perform live at Migos.
Yeah.
And it was just different.
It's the thing is that for me, I feel like it's great for you to evolve and transform and be with the times if you do it well.
Yeah.
Some people don't execute it very well, so that's why I would prefer you just doing what you used to do. But like I feel like every artist needs to be able to evolve with the times, because you are growing up. I mean, when I was 16, I was not rhyming about the stuff that I'm talking about now.
Mm.
Beyonce herself, she was innocent, and then she dropped the visual album, and there's a song called Partition, and that's the kind of vibe that she is at now. She feels sexy, sexual, and she's okay to talk about it because that's the stage she is in at the moment. So, but I think you need to execute it well. Don't force it upon people.
Mm.
Because when it's not authentic, you can see it.
You know? Very much so.
Yeah.
And then your next track, if you'd like to intro.
So the next track is Tsego, The Vibe.
Got the vibe, yeah.
Oh, I love the song. His voice is so amazing.
Didn't he come and perform in Joburg?
Who, Tsego?
Yeah. Yes, no?
What do you mean come perform in Joburg?
He is in Joburg.
You think he's from the States, don't you?
I do.
Okay. He's signed to Family Tree. Who are you thinking?
Masego.
You think Masego?
I'm
Masego.
Like, guys, I'm not.
Yeah, Masego did come.
Yes.
Yeah, no, he did come through.
Ooh.
Now, the Tsego's on that level. Like, I can understand why you can think that.
I know.
And then your third summer banger. Well, yeah, the last one.
The last one is Casper and Your Best. Baby girl. You're my baby girl.
Guys, he performed this on Afternoon Express. I wanted to like swim through the TV.
Really?
I was like, Yona. The thing is, I've heard it.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, cool, sharp. But what I don't know what it is about hearing an artist like sing it in a sort of live setting with a band. It just sounds different, and I think maybe seeing him in his element.
Yeah.
So even when you performed somewhere with what is the event that Moyen went to cover? Casper was there as well. You were here in Cape Town not too long ago.
Sneak Exchange.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
And just seeing you on stage, all of you on stage. There's I don't know what it is. It's like you transcend yourself on stage, and you kind of like just go in.
Yeah.
So what is it about this song that gets you going and that you think gets Casper going?
I think I love the fact that artists can have concepts with songs. Like, this song is a love song, and it's got an African feel to it, and it's just an enjoyable song that your mom can listen to, you can listen to, your little sister can listen to, and everybody can vibe to it.
Mm.
Guys can jam to the song because it's talking about baby girl. The baby girls can jam to the song because it's talking about them.
Mm.
I feel like it caters for everyone at the same time, and it's a feel-good song. It's perfect for the season that we're in right now.
Mm.
And I know how hard he worked on the album, and he loves the song. This is a song that... And you know when an artist is... is passionate about the song that they're pushing at the moment, it makes everybody else passionate about that song as well.
We then asked Unyade to please share a song that she felt kind of, not necessarily made the mark in the game, but made your presence the game sort of felt and seen, and was kind of like, Nadia's here, guys. What was that process kind of, just from the journey between deciding, being in the game, and then hopping onto the song?
So the thing is that, funny enough, the song that I chose, what happened before I had even signed Family Tree, was Amon Tomozana remix that Ricky
I was obsessed with the song.
Ish, that song was amazing. Like, it was, and the remix was even bigger.
It really was.
I love the song.
And I mean, your bars. I was like,
you said you were thicker than Mini Dlamini.
Everybody's so mad about that line.
No, it got the people going.
That's what I wanted. I wanted quotables. I wanted people to be like, she's talking about Boiti, she's talking about Mini. I made that conscious decision to talk about things that were relevant in the game at that time.
Okay.
And this definitely was a breakthrough feature for me, or song for me, because one, it was with very big artists like Questa, Kid Eggs, and Ricky Rick himself, okay, Malum Cool Guys, and DJ Dimples, which was like a lot of the leaders in the game that were on the song. And for me, being in the song kind of solidified myself as the female within that, and had opportunities to perform at the Channel O Awards, and that's a stage I've never been on. And it was the last ones, as well, the last ones were in 2013, so it was an opportunity that would never come again. From there, I was able to be on such an African stage that I got exposed to so many African artists, that's where I was able to link up with someone like Ice Prince. And then we had our collaboration, Sakawena, after that. So a lot more happened for me after that, but the main breakthrough, I feel, was the song. Until today, everybody still talks about this verse, you know?
How do you... what's the word? Not elevate. How do you transcend what is happening on the street and staying true to who you are, your purpose, and kind of silencing the noise? Because I know personally, I'm not famous, but like with the one or two, with the one or two tweet or three, you know, it's made me feel some type of way about myself. And then I feel, you know, that I question everything. I question my contribution to the channel and the whatever. So how do you kind of just lift, and did that, I don't know, did it take time to get there, or was it just a thing of, vale, fuck all this shit, I know why I'm here?
Does Family Tree like give you guys a service,
like, is there a counselor?
Well, the thing is that it used to get to me at the beginning, because I was young and I didn't understand why people would say things that they say. People are very mean, especially on Twitter. People are nicer on Instagram, because you can check out their profile and see their lives. So they think more about what they say on your post, because you can actually go look at their stuff and actually be like, hey, you are so wack. You know, whereas Twitter, all you see is their comments. You don't see their lives. So they can say whatever they want about you. And for me, I've gotten to a point where I don't care anymore, because, like I said, I'm not trying to convince people to be my fans. I'm not going to convince you. If you're going to tell me how much you hate me, you're helping me, because I'm sifting through the rubbish.
Ish.
That means I don't have to focus on you. I can focus on the people that care about what I'm dropping, care about the music I'm making, what I'm wearing, where I'm at, how I'm promoting my music. Those people are the people that I care about. Those are the people that I respond to. People that send hate, I block, because I'm doing you a favor, isn't it? You don't want to see my content. So I'm doing you a favor, and I don't have to hear from you ever again. And believe me, I'm never going to see you in my whole life. I'm never going to remember you in my whole life. But you're going to be so mad that I blocked you on Instagram or Twitter. You're going to be so mad. And every time you see me on TV, you're going to be so mad. Every time you hear me on the radio. But I'm never going to see you on TV. And I'm never going to hear you on radio. As soon as I block, it's like you died, dog. You died? No one, I don't even remember your handle. I don't know who you are. It's Abbas. Like, it's a rap. You know what I mean? That's not me. I love the song so much.
Your bum's also on the cover image.
No, I think you're working overtime to make sure that we definitely understand that you are in fit form. You are
I'm
in
taking this shit
fit
seriously.
Form.
You know, the thing is that I like pissing people off. That's like, for real. Like, people get so mad when I do shit like that I'll do it more. People get mad when you succeed, so you must succeed more. That's exactly what it's supposed to be.
They don't want us to win, so you know what we're going to do? We're going to win more. Yeah, please let the people know where to follow you, what we need to do, where we can catch you in terms of your social media platforms.
Yeah. So Twitter, it's Nadia Nakai. Well, Twitter underscore, what the fuck? Yeah, I'm hungry now. Yep. It's Nadia underscore Nakai, Facebook Nadia Nakai, Instagram Nadia Nakai, Snapchat Nadia Nakai, website www.nadianakai.com.
But thank you so much to everybody for watching.
So much.
Please click subscribe as I learn. Like, we're trying to get to the things, get the numbers rising. We are in a good 5,000 something, but we're trying to get to 10K, guys. Remember we said 10K by December. December is here now.
We need to
just help us out, guys. Christmas present.
You know how you're gonna get 10K in this video? Your caption should be Nadia Nakai clears rumors of Casper pregnancy. Nadia Nakai Casper pregnancy. Is she 8 months pregnant or not? I'm telling you, people are gonna watch that shit.
It's actually a good thing.
Sorry, this girl doesn't stop nicely.
For me.
You wait till the end.
I know.
You've been stressing me the whole ride.
I can see your face in the camera. It's the
like,
best.
No.
That's why I haven't said anything. I'm just like, oh yeah. Are you fine?
I feel like you're not watching the road though.
You'll be alive. Don't worry.
I hope so.
Me, I'm fine. Me. I think it's also because I'm just used to Timmy's driving, so I'm like, I don't even know what it is, whether it's bad, good. For me, it's good. So I'm like, go girl, you do you.